So hi everyone and a very good evening to all of you. Welcome back once again to the channel. So now only 35 days are left for phase 1 of NABARD grade A examination and I hope your preparations are going well. So to give a boost to your preparation, I am here with this particular video where I am going to tell you that how you can score 30 plus marks out of 40 in ESI. In ESI paper, in the 40 questions of ESI, right? And last year the ESI paper was quite typical and there were various questions which were asked, you know, bahut hi ajeeb se questions puche gaye the, right? So considering the pattern of the examination, I am here with this video and we will be discussing that how you guys can score 30 plus marks out of 40 in the ESI paper, alright, and I will also be telling you about the phase 2 ESI as well, ki aapko descriptive ke liye kaise tayari karni chahiye, how you should be preparing for the descriptive part of ESI, theek hai? So let's start with this particular video, 5-10 minute ki baat hai, uske baad phir apne apne ghar. So first of all, let me tell you the exam pattern. I hope you guys must be knowing this, but phir bhi main ek bar bata deta hun. ESI is asked in both phase 1 and phase 2, unlike RBI. Because in RBI they ask ESI only in the phase 2, but in NABARD they ask in both phase 1 and phase 2. In phase 1 there are 40 questions of 1 marks, right? 40 questions of 1 marks are there. In phase 2 question there is only one paper of ESI and NIADIC combined. Total 30 questions are there, but out of those 30 questions, 15 questions consisting of both 2 markers and 1 markers are there, right? And in descriptive also there is one common paper of ESI and NIADIC. 6 questions are there, out of which 3 questions belong to ESI and 3 questions belong to ARD, right? So this is the exam pattern. I hope you guys know this. Now these are the topics from where the questions are asked. These are the topic from where the questions are asked in NABARD examination. The most important topic from where the questions are asked is the government schemes and campaigns or other any initiatives, right? So this, guys, is the most important topic. Out of 40 questions, you will get at least 10 to 12 questions from this single topic only. So you can realize how much important government schemes are, right? So government schemes and campaigns, then after that reports and indices, at least 3 to 4 questions. Kam se kam 3 se 4 questions to isme aate hi hai. And Suraj sir has recently done the phase 1 and phase 2 trend analysis for 2-3 years. So you guys, I would recommend you guys to watch that video. Wahan se aapko samajh mein aayega ki kahan se kitne kitne questions aate hain. Alright, so reports and indices, very very important. Now here what you have to do is, reports and indices mein aapko kya karna hai, kaise karna hai, that I also be telling you after this particular side. Let's first focus on the topics. Let's try and understand ki kaun kaun se topics se questions aate hain. International and regional organization, WTO, IMF, World Bank, OECD, Asian Development Bank, Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank, etc. WHO also. National and international current events, ye to bhai aana hi aana hai, ESI hai to, theek hai. Then committees, questions from committees are asked, questions based on GDP forecast, the GDP forecast which have been recently done by you know, the major organizations are asked. Yeah, this is something which is very different for you guys. Constitutional ke article ye log poochte hai related to social issues, related to social issues and panchayati raj and municipality, right? So there are only 3-4 chapters from a book that you have to study to cover these articles, and these are very straightforward and basic questions, theek hai? And then of course questions, some questions are also asked from the static, economic and social issues. All right so these are the topics. Now how you guys have to approach these topics, let me tell you this. So first of all, government schemes and campaign, you don't have to go anywhere, you don't have to go anywhere for schemes in news. So I just in the previous video I explained everything about the schemes, right? In that video I told you guys that there are two types of schemes that you have to cover. Number one is the schemes in news and number two is the static schemes or the landmark scheme. In that video I have explained completely that how you have to cover these schemes. For schemes in news, you have to cover PIB 247 of at least last 6 months. वैसे तो मैं एक साल बोल के चलता हूँ, but right now the time is very short, so I am recommending you to cover the PIB 247 of at least 6 months. Then for static schemes and landmark schemes, if you are an enrolled student, the 3 comprehensive PDFs have been provided. You have to go through those PDFs. If you are not an enrolled student, you can refer to the schemes playlist on YouTube and also the revision sessions which I am conducting for NABARD examination. Okay? Reports and indices. What all you have to do in reports and indices? You have to do budget, you have to do economic survey, periodic labor force survey, NFHS 5, AISHE, ASER report, new education policy, census, state of forest report, 15 finance commission, multidimensional poverty index. All of them have been covered on YouTube. ठीक है, सारी चीजें मैं YouTube पे कवर करा चुका हूं किसी ना किसी सेशन में. सो इफ यू हैव बीन प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर लास्ट लेट्स से 7-8 months, सो आप सबने ये सब पढ़ा होगा. एंड इन द कोर्स देर इज अ फोल्डर विच इज नोन एज एनुअल सर्वे. इन द कोर्स देर इज अ फोल्डर विच इज एनुअल सर्वे. ऑल ऑफ दीज रिपोर्ट्स, ऑल ऑफ दीज सर्वेज हैव बीन प्रोवाइडेड इन दिस पर्टिकुलर सर्वे. एंड द नॉन एनरोल्ड स्टूडेंट, यू गाइस हैव टू सर्च ऑन YouTube और यू मस्ट बी मेकिंग नोट्स फ्रॉम द PIB सेशन, तो वहां से आपको मिल ही जाएगा. बजट और इकोनॉमिक सर्वे का तो स्पेशल सेशन ही हुआ था ऑन द डे ऑफ सर्वे एंड ऑन द डे ऑफ बजट, तो यू गाइस कैन वॉच दोज सेशंस. ठीक है, एंड अलॉन्ग विद दिस यू हैव टू कवर द रिपोर्ट्स एंड इंडाइसेस ऑफ ऑल द इंपॉर्टेंट इंटरनेशनल ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस. लाइक वर्ल्ड बैंक अगर कोई रिपोर्ट निकाल रहा है, IMF निकाल रहा है, राइट, एनी इंडाइसेस रिलीज बाय WTO, सो ऑल ऑफ दीज यू हैव टू कवर. एंड फ्रॉम वेयर यू विल कवर दैट? स्पॉटलाइट. राइट, फ्रॉम वेयर यू विल कवर दिस? स्पॉटलाइट. ठीक है, इंटरनेशनल एंड रीजनल ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस लाइक WTO, वर्ल्ड बैंक, IMF, OECD, वर्ल्ड इकोनॉमिक फोरम, WHO, आसियान, इन सब के बारे में भी आपको पढ़ना है. सो वॉट ऑल यू कैन डू टू स्टडी दिस इज टू रेफर एनी स्टैंडर्ड बुक ऑन इंडियन इकोनॉमी. एंड देर आर टू बुक्स विच आर सजेस्टेड. वन इज बाय मिस्टर नितिन सिंघानिया एंड वन इज बाय मिस्टर रमेश सिंह. Either of the books you can follow. इनमें से कोई भी किताब चलेगी, उसमें आपको ये वाला चैप्टर मिल जाएगा where these explanations of all these organizations are given. ठीक है जी. Now national and international current events के लिए तो of course PIB 247 for 6 months and spotlight for the last 3 months. The last 3 months are very important. अगर आपने पहले इसका भी पढ़ रखा है then obviously you have an edge, right? Above that candidate जो कि सिर्फ 3 महीने का पढ़ के जाएगा. बट द लास्ट 3 months आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. द 3 months आर जुलाई अगस्त एंड सेप्टेंबर. एंड फॉर द मंथ ऑफ अक्टूबर यू हैव टू कवर टिल 10th ऑफ अक्टूबर न्यूज. 10 अक्टूबर तक की न्यूज आपको पढ़ के जानी है बिकॉज येस दे आस्क क्वेश्चन इवन 1 week बिफोर द एग्जामिनेशन फ्रॉम द न्यूज विच आर रिलीज 1 week बिफोर द एग्जामिनेशन. So 10th अक्टूबर तक का आपको करके जाना है स्पॉटलाइट. दैट इज इंपॉर्टेंट एंड ऑल्सो द PIB, राइट, कमिटीज, PIB 247 एंड स्पॉटलाइट, राइट, GDP फोरकास्ट. देर विल बी अ स्पेशल सेशन दैट विल बी कंडक्टेड बाय नेहा मैम इन विच शी विल बी टीचिंग यू द GDP फोरकास्ट ऑफ ऑल द इंपॉर्टेंट इंटरनेशनल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. Now this is something which is new for you and you have to do it because 3 to 4 questions and at least 2-3 questions they are asking continuously from the articles from the constitution and you have to read only 4 chapters from a very famous book, Lakshmikant. ठीक है, Lakshmikant, Indian Polity. You have to read only 4 chapters. These are fundamental rights, fundamental duties, DPSP. DPSP stands for Directive Principles of State Policy and Panchayats and Municipalities. Right, panchayats and municipalities are basically the 73rd and 74th Constitutional Amendment Act. So you have to read these 4 chapters and you have to mug up the articles which are given in these chapters. Okay, like for example Article 14, Equality Before Law. Right, for example Article 243, Panchayats. For example, इस तरीके के fundamental rights के सारे articles, fundamental duties के एक ही article है वैसे उसका. DPSP ke only the important ones that you feel that these are important and can be asked. And most importantly, in DPSP chapter, you have to focus on only those articles which are related to the social issues, right? Which are related to the social issues. Gandhian principles pe ya socialist principle pe jo bhi DPSP hai, wo aapko karke jaane hai, right? And last but not the least, the static part that you can cover from either of these books. नितिन सिंघानिया और रमेश सिंह, दोनों में से कोई एक पढ़नी है, दोनों नहीं पढ़नी है, ऑफ कोर्स दैट इज नॉट रिक्वायर्ड. एंड ओनली सिलेक्टेड चैप्टर्स, सिलेक्टेड चैप्टर्स कैसे सिलेक्ट करेंगे, बाय पुटिंग सिलेबस इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू ऑफ ESI एंड कीपिंग दिस बुक. ये आपको सिलेक्टेड चैप्टर्स पढ़ के जाने हैं. ओके, नाउ अगर आपके पास टाइम नहीं है, मान लो यू गाइज आर शॉर्ट ऑफ टाइम, तो यू गाइज कैन अभी फॉर फेज वन ओनली यू कैन लीव दिस पार्ट एज वेल, बिकॉज द आइडिया इज नॉट टू स्कोर 100%, द आइडिया इज टू स्कोर 30+ marks. अगर आप इतना करके जाओगे तो आप 35 भी ला सकते हो. ऑलराइट, तो अगर आपके पास टाइम की कमी आती है तो सबसे कम इंपॉर्टेंस आपको इस वाले पार्ट को देनी है, बिकॉज दिस पार्ट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर द डिस्क्रिप्टिव पोर्शन. डिस्क्रिप्टिव पोर्शन के लिए बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है. अब देखो, मैं अभी पढ़ने के लिए इसलिए कह रहा हूं बिकॉज आफ्टर फेज वन यू माइट नॉट गेट मच टाइम टू रीड ऑल दीज बुक्स, बिकॉज दैट टाइम यू वुड बी बिजी विद द डिस्क्रिप्टिव आंसर राइटिंग प्रैक्टिस, इजंट इट, एंड रिविजन में ही टाइम निकल जाता है, एक महीने का ही टाइम होता है बस आफ्टर फेज वन. So I suggest you to cover this right now. Okay. So these are the sources that you have to follow, and if you do this, then you can definitely score 30+ marks in the phase one in ESI part. Now talking about descriptive portion of ESI. So as I just told you, these are the two books that you have to follow, and if you are an enrolled student, you don't have to go through any book. You just have to follow the course. Jo course mein अनुसर ने क्लासेस ले रखी हैं, दैट क्लासेस यू हैव टू फॉलो. उसके अलावा यू डोंट हैव टू डू एनीथिंग. बट द नॉन एनरोल्ड स्टूडेंट्स, आइदर ऑफ दीज बुक्स विल वर्क. एंड हाउ यू हैव टू प्रैक्टिस द डिस्क्रिप्टिव पार्ट, लेट्स से यू हैव रीड अ चैप्टर इंडियन इकोनॉमी, नॉट इंडियन इकोनॉमी, लेट्स से एग्रीकल्चर. देन आफ्टर रीडिंग द चैप्टर एग्रीकल्चर, लेट्स से यू हैव रीड एग्रीकल्चर फ्रॉम 1947 टू 1991. सो यू कैन योरसेल्फ मेक अ क्वेश्चन, फॉर एग्जाम्पल, discuss the status of agriculture since independence till the economic reforms of 1991 in India. So you can write whatever you have read, right? And try to make short notes. Try to make short notes out of these books so that you can quote. Or agar koi data hai, to data ke liye aap alag se ek data bank banao so that you can quote those data while writing a descriptive answer. Theek hai, baaki descriptive ke liye aur detail mein discuss karenge after the phase one. And now of course mock test, although mock test जो है सिर्फ only ESI का नहीं लगाना, आपको सबका लगाना है. And at least 10 mock test आपको solve करके जाने हैं. बिना 10 mock test लगाए paper देने मत जाना. कुछ लोग कलाकार ऐसे होते हैं जो sectional wise mock test लगा रहे हैं. Some people are there who are just attempting the mock test of the merit section and they are not doing the practice of the qualifying section. Please do not do this. I warn you guys, please do not do this, because last year there were thousands of students who could not qualify the exam because they could not qualify the qualifying section. All right, kai sections jo the wo chhoot gaye unke, kai sections mein time nahi manage ho paya. So please do not do this. You have a 2-hour exam, and in those 2 hours you have to solve all the 8 sections including qualifying and merit section. So complete the mock test, theek hai, and not only attempting the mock test, you have to analyze it as well, because without analyzing you won't be able to do the self analysis. Aapka ho hi nahi payega ki aap kahan pe galti kar rahe ho, kya galti kar rahe ho, kya nahi kar rahe ho. All right, and finally, do not repeat those mistakes, the mistakes once you have identified. Now how to analyze the mock test, main aapko basic example de deta hu, baaki Anuj sir ne bahut detail mein वीडियो बना रखी है. एनालाइजिंग द मॉक टेस्ट में यू हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई दैट इन विच एरिया यू आर वीक, राइट, नंबर वन. नंबर टू, इन विच सब्जेक्ट, विद इन अ सब्जेक्ट, राइट. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आइडेंटिफाई द सब्जेक्ट, देन विद इन द सब्जेक्ट, लेट्स से इन ESI, इन ESI यू आर नॉट एबल टू सॉल्व द क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम रिपोर्ट्स एंड इंडाइसेस, सो दैट मींस दैट यू आर वीक इन दैट एरिया, सो यू हैव टू वर्क ऑन दैट एरिया, राइट. उसके अलावा थर्ड थिंग दैट यू हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई इज, आर यू डूइंग एनी सिली मिस्टेक्स. Of course, everyone does that. So, how you can avoid those silly mistakes, right? And number four, always there are certain questions in the examination when we attempt any examination. Always there are certain questions which we realize later after giving the exam. We realize that okay, I could have attempted this question. So, such questions you have to identify that okay, this was doable and I didn't do it, right? And then applying all these things in the next mock test. All right. So guys, you have to attempt the mock test and at least 10 mock tests. So I hope the message is clear that how you can score 30 plus marks out of 40 in phase 1 in ESI part, right? And as you know, NABARD grade A complete crash course has been launched. If you want to ask anything related to this, you can call on 9999466225, right? Okay, so that's it for today. If you guys have any doubt with respect to ESI, you can write down in the comment section. I will be solving all those doubts, and I will see you in some of the next video with some of the next with some of the other issues that you guys are facing. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.